What is going on, guys? It's Bucky, and welcome back to your 27th C++ tutorial. And this tutorial is actually going to be a pretty fun one because we're going to be talking about random numbers, what they are, a couple functions that are going to help us build random number generators, and I'm actually going to teach you guys how to build a sweet random number generator. So before we get into that, we need to include a header file. So include, and the header file is called CSTDLIB from the C standard library, and we include this because we want to use a function from it called rand, not run, rand. And what this does is whenever you call this, it basically returns to you a random number. So let's see, let's run it, and we got 41 in this case. So as you can see, whenever we print out rand, it pretty much takes a random number and gives it to you. So you're saying, wow, there you go, there's our random number generator, perfect. Well, there are actually a couple problems with rand, and we're going to be talking about those later on. But for now, I want to show you guys how to build a basic random number generator. And let's go ahead and just call rand like 25 times. So let's go ahead and make a for loop, and go ahead and make int x set equal to 1, and make x is less than 25, and of course x plus plus. So now we have a loop that's going to run 25 times or sometime around that. So now let's just go ahead and see out, let's just go ahead and see out rand and see what happens. And then might as well end that line so it looks nice and pretty. Let's go ahead and print it and see what we get. Okay, so it looks like we're getting a huge list of random numbers. Alright, looks pretty good. But you know, what if I'm gonna build a random number generator and I don't want numbers quite this big in tens and thousands and stuff like that. Say we're building a random number generator to simulate people rolling dice or something. Well, I only want the numbers 1 to 6. So here's a neat little trick where you can get that result set. In order to get a certain set of numbers, go ahead and take your rand and put modulus 6. What this is going to do is it's going to give you 6 random numbers. It's going to take a big number like 25,000 or something, divide it by 6 and give you the remainder of that. So the remainder, whenever you divide by 6, can either be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Whenever you divide by 6, you're limited to only the number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You can't have 6 as a remainder because anything divided by 6 with 6 remainder, it would just be another 1. So you can say, alright, well, I'm trying to simulate a dice here, and they have the numbers 1 through 6, not 0 through 5. So we got 6 numbers, but we don't want 0 through 5. We want 1 through 6. So, Bucky, can you just show me how to take all these numbers and shift them, add 1 to them? Well, that is very simple. Just go ahead and surround your rand 6 and just put 1 plus. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to take a random number, divide it by 6, and whatever the remainder is, which would be 0 through 5, it would add 1 to it. So now you're getting 1 to 6. So now you can see that 0 is eliminated, and we have 6 now. So 1, 2, let me find a 3, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So that is how you build a random number generator using, you know, a specific result set. So remember, however many numbers you want, you put as a modulus of rand, and however many you want to shift it by, just add that many to it. But let's go ahead and take a little closer look at this random number generator. Okay, let's read these numbers. 5, 6, 5, 1, 1, 5. Okay, they look like, they're pretty random to me. Let's go ahead and run it again. 5, 6, 5, 1, 1, 5. That seems kind of familiar. Let's go ahead and run this one more time. 5, 6, 5, 1, 1, 5. Alright. What's going on with our random generator? We built this program perfectly, which we did. So, I mean, we use random. Alright, everything's good to go. So what's the deal? Why did it give us the same numbers every time? Well, in order to understand this, I need to talk to you guys about computers and random numbers. Now listen very closely because this is actually pretty important. No computer random number generator is truly random. The truth is that computers are not humans. Computers have to follow a certain algorithm, a certain set of instructions, a certain pattern. So for example, whenever you go into a casino and you see those automated slot machines and it looks like people are just spinning and it's giving them random numbers. Well, the truth is that it's not actually giving them truly random numbers. Those slot machines, even though they're supposed to be a random number generator, they have to follow a certain algorithm, a certain pattern. And, you know, whenever you're looking at, like, game shows, or whenever you buy an electronic and it flashes, like, random lights, well, those lights are not random either. Everything in electronics that is supposed to be random is not random. It's a computer. It has to follow a complex algorithm and a complex pattern. Now, the reason that these are so complex is that's what gives the appearance that it's random to humans. We don't understand this algorithm right away. Only the computer does. So whenever we see numbers like this, 5, 6, 5, 1, 1, 5, 3, 6, those are random numbers to us, but the computer, it's really just following a big algorithm. So if you're saying, alright, so whenever we're building games and stuff, we don't want our numbers to be predictable, so what can we do in order to change that algorithm a little bit? Well, let's go ahead and let me include another, well, I won't do this yet, but the rand function right here runs on a very complex algorithm, and I don't know what the algorithm is, and I don't think many people do, but it's basically a large function that computers, or excuse me, that humans aren't meant to understand. So what C++, the developers, allowed us to do is seed a random number, and you use that in a function called srand. Now what this function does is it allows us to pass in a random number, any number we want, like 67, and now whenever we build it, we get different results, 621616. Now let's go ahead and pass in another one, like 215, and now we get, you know, 41311 or whatever. So whenever we seed a random number, we throw, you know, any old random number in there and it changes the algorithm. So now I don't even know, you know, what happens when I type in 43. I get truly random numbers. So if you're saying, alright, so let's go ahead and put 43 in there every time and we get 44151. Okay, now let's run it again. 44151. OMG, Bucky, what are you doing? All you did is you changed the algorithm a little bit, and you know, we didn't really make it a truly random number generator. We just gave it a different algorithm to follow. Well, alright, I'll show you guys one last trick, and in order to do this, we need to include another header file, include, and this is called ctime. And what this does is it allows us to access the clock or the time in our computer. And now let's go ahead and pass in a function called time, and as a parameter of time, not Tima, time, go ahead and pass in 0. Now let's go ahead and run this and see what happens before I explain it. Okay, 2, 5, 2, 2. Okay, let's run it again. 4, 6, 1, 4. Sweet. And one more time. 5, 4, 6, 4, 6. So now we have a random number generator that works perfectly. So now let me tell you guys why. We know that we can use srand to change the algorithm a little bit, but if we just threw the same number in here every time, it would just, you know, have a different algorithm, but with the same results every time. So what time zero does is time zero calculates the seconds since like 1970 or something, and what this does is every second this value is changing. So now it might be 1,000,000 seconds, now 1,000,001, now 1,000,002. People don't have access to how many seconds are, you know, counting since 1970, so this gives the appearance that this number generator is truly random now. So this value is ever changing, and that's why every single time we run our program, we're going to get a different result. So that is how people build random number generators that are is truly random, or they're not truly random, but they're as random as we can make them. So again, what we did is, here's the algorithm. All rand does is it rands a complex algorithm. Srand allows us to throw a number in there to change the algorithm a little bit, and time zero counts the number of seconds, and this value is changing every single second. So that's why, since this value is changing, this whole algorithm is changing every single second, and that allows us to make a truly random number generator. So there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching, and don't forget to include your header files, because you can't use this program without it. And there you go. I'll see you guys next time.